everybody. Welcome to Battle of British Columbia 4 here in beautiful Vancouver, Canada. My name's Laird. I'm joined by Rodney on the mic. How you doing today, brother?
I'm doing really good. Doing even better now that we're getting ready to commentate some of this hot singles action. Now, of course, doubles wrapped up really strong last night. And as at any tournament, if doubles goes well and squash strike goes well, it's a pretty good sign that singles is going to be even better. So let's see if it holds up to that statement.
Yeah, shout out to the TOs and everything for getting everything set up and run properly and everything. Shout out to production working behind the camera. And, man, shout out to our players for making this event as hype as it has been so far, because I don't know if any of y'all catch doubles yesterday, but there were some heavy hitters there.
There was certainly some heavy hitters, man. Of course, we had, like, some of the old classics, like ESIM and MVD teaming up. We had some of, like, that new blood as well jumping into the mix. Base Mates and Tilde, certainly a fantastic team to see. Ken and T teamed together as well, which is another strong one. I mean, anytime any player from Japan at that level gets together with another player from Japan, it's going to get scary in brackets. So.
Honestly, the amount of international talent we have at this event has been immense. I mean, you have Team Japan coming up, I believe, like Shuton, and you know, obviously T-Ken, and then somebody else whose name escapes me at the moment. But like, they're here. You got Spain coming in with Siski and Andres, and then you have France, Gluto and Leon are here. As well as, you know, America showing up in full force, Canada, you know, Pacific Northwest, and also Eastern Canada, like Toronto, Montreal, that area. And you know, speaking of them, I think a team that kind of went a little under the radar yesterday was Soar and Supergirl Kells.
That's right.
Because they actually took the tournament with the eventual winners to, like, last game, last hit situation.
Yeah.
And so it was a really good day yesterday. But then again, we're on singles now.
We're on singles. This is a different format. That's right.
This is the moneymaker here.
This is the moneymaker. I mean, there is money to be made in duds, but it ain't like in singles. So, but yeah, big shout out to Soar and Supergirl Kells, of course. I mean, I talk about how good team synergy has to be to propel yourself through bracket. I don't know how much more synergy you need than teaming with the siblings. So,
yeah.
Big shout out to them, of course. Big shout out to, of course, all of you that are tuning in with us here. BTS Smash number two. We got our players locked in on the big stage right now, just getting their tweets out, getting that Discord banter together. In the meantime, while you're here, be sure to share that Twitch link. We just started out today. We're trying to double the viewers of last night. Hell, let's be real. Maybe even triple the viewers.
Yeah, so. Man. Honestly, this event is definitely something you want to tune into. And this all aspects of it. If you're a Melee fan, we got some hot Melee action here. We got HBox here. We got, you know, Mango, Zane, all your favorites are here. And then, you know, Ultimate, ESAM, you got a bunch of the other, like, Pacific Northwest talent who definitely are incredibly underrated as a region.
Yeah.
I think as a whole, this region, you know, Oregon with Seattle and then British Columbia as well, might be one of the stronger regions in the world.
I agree.
And so if none of y'all have been exposed to that yet, you are in for a treat.
Yeah, most certainly in for a treat. I know, I think I seen Big D playing last night in doubles. I can't remember who he was teaming with for the life of me, but you know, anytime you see him sit down onto the stage, you know it's going to be trouble. But speaking of two players that are about to be in the trouble right here, we got our two competitors. That's right. Throw it up, man. Let them know how you're feeling.
Yeah.
He's feeling confident.
Now, I don't know. I don't know what your opinion on this is, Rodney, but some of the early pools matches I get are always my favorites because they're players I never see, you know, anywhere. Like, not notable players. And then they show up and they just, like, do some cool stuff that I'm not expecting. And then I see them later in bracket. And I'm like, who is this guy? You know, he's taking heads right now.
Yeah. I think pools, especially at an event of this size, is a good way for, like, local killers, regional killers, maybe even players that could be their first time coming over here to the States who have never really played on a stage this big. It's just a good chance for them, you know, to strut their stuff and show the world what they got. So, first match of the day here for singles and ultimate. We got a Bowser and we got a Piranha Plant. We're Super Mario Bros. In this thing up. Let's get it.
Yes,
Noot,
sir.
Noot versus Quiper.
I love these two characters, man. Bowser has been probably the best heavy in the game. I don't think anyone would argue with me there. But, you know, Piranha Plant's a character who was kind of added as a joke character and then, you know, has a very dedicated community and fan base.
No, that's
and,
facts.
You know, they have a very strong neutral B in that Fatui. And I feel like Bowser might struggle a lot with that. And then again,
you can just F smash. You know what I'm saying? You recover incorrectly, guess what? You're going to get smash attack. Great stuff right here from Noot right here, giving Quiper the boot as we kick this thing off. Belly time.
Playing a very strong defensive game there is Noot. Honestly, I'm loving what they're doing with their movement and stuff. They're keeping Quiper away from center stage, and then they're doing a good job of corralling them, going for some heavy-hitting options that maybe Quiper can't react to in time.
No, that's 100%, man. I like that breakdown. You know, another thing that we're seeing here from Quiper is, like, he's trying to play the you're a big character, you're going to throw something heavy out, and then I'm going to nair out his shield and start the party, because I think Piranha Plant has like a frame 2 jab and one of the strongest up smashes in the game, so his out of shield game is pretty intense, but
right.
We're just not seeing it here. Quiper, unfortunately, is not quiping correctly. Another thing, Newt is going ham.
Another thing about this character, Rodney, is that Piranha Plant's incredibly heavy.
Yes.
Not quite as heavy as Bowser, but still much heavier than you would expect them to be. And then again, when you have Bowser's firepower and attack strength, that's a non-factor.
Yeah, 100%. I like this ledge trapping, too, that we've been seeing quite a bit of. You know, trying to use down tilt to try to catch Kuiper on the way up with up special. High recovery there. Lets him off the hook. Has to figure out a way to get this first stock taken. Because right now, Newt is tapped into big guy mode. There it is. Tapping into a page out of Newt's book. Just tossing out the F smashing.
Sometimes it just works, especially when it's that long and that quick, yeah, as Piranha Plants is. And, you know, goes for it again. This is a nice starter there. But tossing in the poison cloud, Newt doesn't even care. When you have this much of a lead, Rodney, it's very, very easy to get carried away and start going for stuff. But honestly, you're Bowser. You're at 51%. You got an extra insurance stock when you need it. And yeah, excellent back air to capitalize on the Patooie, catching your opponent in place, unable to act out of it.
Yeah, that was a bit of a spanking right there. Now, you know, a lesser Bowser, you can probably go blow for blow, trade a little bit with them because, again, you know, not the quickest, you know, guy in the world. Piranha Plant, of course, has some pretty speedier options, namely that frame 2 jab really gets the party started on Bowser. But this Bowser seems to be well-seasoned and well-poised right here, knows exactly what it is that he needs to do. So I'm excited to see what we see for game number two. Some adjustments definitely need to be made.
Yeah, I would like to see Kuiper camp a little bit more, getting a little bit too close to personal, but I am seeing a character switch here, Rodney. We are going to be seeing the Byleth come out. And you know what? I'd say this is a fair counter pick.
I'm with it. I'm about it. One DLC character to the other. Let's go ahead and run it up right here. Vega stage type A.
And I really want to see a little bit of those uppy strings that Leo has made famous with his character, because they can work very, very efficiently on Bowser with his weight class and everything. But we are going to see a couple grab combos start things off. But then again, those Nair combos, Nair back air, one of the strongest combos in the game. Both players falling a little bit too close to the sun. And I think that's a good trade for Kuiper.
Yeah, we'll take those most definitely. Okay, but this stock starting out very similar to how the last one did early on the special. Going to go for the F2 just to try to pin you down. Speaking of pin you down, there's Flamethrower. Belly time. Boom.
I love how Newt is kind of playing Bowser like a sortie almost, Rodney, because they're using their disjoints really well. They're faster boxing options up close to personal, and then just whip punishing on that F smash. They take an early stock, only 15% to their name, and they're looking to close this one out in maybe a minute 30.
Let's see if he can speed run it. Spring game's done quick, coming soon. Gets the 1-2 jab. Nothing off it. Love that. Up B out of shield. Where are we going with it?
Okay, has again, him in the corner, too.
Yeah, the corner control has been just completely on point here for Newt. Man, Kuiper, of course, struggling right now.
That's a forward air.
Goodbye.
Or a down air. All right. Good stuff there. Wow. Okay, so I was expecting the forward air because that was dead. That was no jump on Byleth. You know, you had the up off stage, but they just went for the throat on that one.
Yeah. I mean, sometimes you just got to send that message like, hey, man, it ain't even close. I gave you that first stock, okay? That was a pity stock.
Yeah.
The rest of this game is not going to go in your favor. So, of course, big shout out to those first two players there. It takes a lot to get up on the big stage and do this at an event of this stature.
Yeah, and Battle to kick BC things off as well.
Four. Yeah, no doubt about it, man. Battle of BC number four, Newt, and Kuiper putting on a show. But it was Newt, like I said earlier, that gave Kuiper the boot. Got his ass right up out of here.
Yeah, man. I mean, dude, those F-smashes, those back airs, everything. Closing out stocks early is something you definitely need to do against the heavier weight class in the game. And, you know, again, with the kill power that Bowser brings to the table, it was no surprise there they were able to capitalize in the big way. I did really like the Byleth switch, though. I think they got a couple up air strings into those nairs and then into, like, the side Bs and everything, and maybe played a little bit more defensively. They probably could have found themselves in a better position. But the big deal there is the fact that they were just kind of out in the open. Their shield was down whenever Newt expected them to be. So, you know, Kuiper, excellent showing. They still have a loser's run to make, though.
Yeah, that's right. There's still always the party bracket for sure. But, yeah, you know, I think when it comes to Bowser as well, he has some very specific combo starters. I mean, he's not a combo, you know, oriented character. But, you know, anytime I see Nair immediately out of shield into something, I'm like, okay, this is Bowser doing what Bowser's supposed to do.
Right.
And it's unfortunate because I think, you know, Byleth, of course, like you said, has the ability to kind of smack Bowser around, especially if you can get Bowser off of his feet. But every Nair backer, every Nair forwarder, you know what I'm saying? Like, that stuff starts to add up over a while. And unfortunately enough, Kuiper just could not close it out. But where Kuiper fell, let's see if the next two players prevail.
Yeah, so we don't know who's sitting down at the setup just yet, but man, I just want to take a look into the atmosphere of this event. I mean, we're right in the thick of it. We got pools going on over there, melees on the other side of the room.
Yeah.
And, you know, honestly, it's so cool. You're just seeing, like, a bunch of players intermingling with top players and then, you know, commentators hanging out with them all as well, event organizers. The TOs have been doing an amazing job, pool captains, all these guys.
Yeah, the staff here certainly works hard. And I was a firm believer, you know, a couple years ago, like, yo, Canada is a region worth going to, friends.
Oh, God, yeah.
You know, but the issue was, like, they're going to Gamo back in the day, or like Canada Cup, and they're in Mississauga. And I'm like, yo, Mississauga is not Toronto. You're like, I mean, you got to – Mississauga's where the event is, but you got to go out into the city and travel. I think when people started doing that, then they started to understand the beauty of Canada. And then, of course, Vancouver doing something very similar. Here we are on the university, one of the prettiest universities I've ever been
to. That's what I'm saying, dude.
But it gets prettier than this, though. You go out into the city, cross the bridge down to the downtown area, and it gets really, really nice. So, friends, if you're watching this from the venue, which you probably shouldn't be listening to Laird and I from the venue, you should be in the audience getting hype.
Yeah, you should be hyping up these players. And, oh, yeah. Mama.
Yeah, there he is. But if you are listening to us, go downtown for sure.